The kick will go to Smith at the 4. And down at the 20-yard line, that's where Penn State will go to work. They only converted one of these situations in Tuscaloosa last year. A 3rd and 7+. 3rd and 8 here. Bolden, plenty of time. Fires a strike. Got a man, and it's Justin Brown. So they're 1 for 1. They're as good as they were a year ago. 2nd down and 6 at the 41. Red weaves his way to a 1st down. Nice run. Right up the middle. Out to the 49.
Hightower and Upshaw's up here on the end. They're both on the ends, going to rush the passer.
They show blitz and the inside handoff to Red. 1st down and more. Nice play call there on a 3rd down and 6. They got 9. As they shuttled around on that offensive line with a Coley out. And here's Red again. Nice second effort to get down to the 35. A pickup of 4. Red. He's close, but I don't think so.
It looked like he was going to get it for sure, and then he got pushed back.
Here's a huge play in the opening quarter of this game. 4th and 1 yard. It comes a blitz inside, and Bolden rolls with it, looking for the sticks. I don't know.
He reached the ball.
He reached
the football, Brad, and I think that's what got him the 1st down.
Boy, they put it right on the line, and now they do say 1st down. This one will be from 43 yards out. Trying to pick up his 1st 3-pointer of the year. It would be big to end this opening drive. Lewis, kick on the way, and it is good. Dual return man inside the 30-yard line from Cody Mandel. Oh, man, they got close to him. And it's a short kick. Fair catch called for and taken at the 37-yard line. 39-yard punt is off. Penn State, their defense holds. Their offense looked good on their opening drive. They lead by 3. Bolden, look out. Got rid of it to Red. He's got blockers in front. Uh-oh, he's got a 1st down and then some. He almost squirted out the backside. There's a flag down, though, at the 41-yard line.
Holding. Offense 54. 10-yard penalty for the spot of the foul. Repeat 3rd down.
And he might get a chance at this one. Runs up under the 32, and he's buried at the 32. Great hustle to get down to make the stop for no gain. McCarron fires across the middle and throws a strike to Brandon Gibson. Let's just see if it's enough for the 1st down, though.
And they run to that distance, try to turn and catch the ball with enough after, right at the catch, to get the 1st down.
Short by just the tape at the end of the lengths. Again, Justin Brown and Davon Smith are both back deep.
Fake.
And they pick up.
He didn't get it.
No, they didn't. Penn State picks it up. Smelly was the ball carrier. He thinks he got it. And 1st down.
By a nose.
Not even. A half a nose. Your nose instead of mine. As he comes out as an extra wide receiver. On 3rd down and 6. McCarron in the shotgun in an empty backfield. Deep middle and caught. What a catch by Marquise Mays right in front of Nick Suke. Somebody's got to make those big plays, and he just made a big one right down the middle. McCarron blitz across the middle this time to Bell, and Bell rings it up for another 1st down near the 11-yard line. All 3 receivers to the right, and now Mays comes back in motion to the left side. There's the play fake Todd called for. There's the throw, and it's complete to Mays inside the 10 and down near the 5. Fires to the end zone. Touchdown, Alabama. Michael Williams, the tight end. McCarron, good-looking drive for him. Threw some strikes, including that one to his tight end for the touchdown. Alabama might bring some heat on the punt. They did, but he got it away. And a fair catch called for and taken just inside the 45-yard line. Alabama is going to have good starting field position. And he flanks A.J. McCarron in the gun. McCarron with the quick outs. Got it to Smelly, the tight end. Nice gain into Penn State territory as we check in with Robert Flores. Robert, they spread him out now and put Brandon Lewis in as a big fullback in front of Lacy. He'll lead the way. Lacy's got a first down. Picked up five. Here comes a blitz. Screen pass should be the right play for Lacy. A nice job, though, by Jordan Hill, who is one of our impact players, to get in there from defensive tackle and make the stop. McCarron's hit his last seven passes. This time he hands it off. A good tough run again, this time by Trent Richardson, who just checked back in there on a second down and four. On the stretch play, it's Richardson. And there he goes on one of those runs that I just talked about. All the way down inside the 10. 22-yard field goal attempt to try to make it a touchdown difference. Kick on the way, and he just tucked it inside the right upright. Field goal is good. Alabama and Nick Saban add to their lead. 10:08 remaining first quarter, and now 10-3 Alabama. Marquise Mays waiting on the kick from Alex Butterworth. Third straight time Penn State held without a first down. And this punt takes a Penn State bounce. Very good one inside the 30-yard line. They've got the lead as they start this drive here with 8:24 to go in the half. Oh, Trent Richardson's leveled by Devin Still.
Now similar to the first play of the game. A handoff to Trent Richardson. Devin Still.
Mandel to punt around his own 15-yard line. High snap. And a bad punt off the side of his foot. But it takes an Alabama roll. It's going to be scooped up by Justin Brown. And somebody called fair catch, I think. So Derek Moy, their biggest receiver, has only had one pass aimed his way so far. Bolden down the middle. Complete. And he got it to Justin Brown for the first down. Upshaw, one of the captains of the defense that Todd talked about a few moments ago. Bolden in the pocket, fires across the middle. Got his tight end. And the ball comes out. Alabama's got it. Unless the play was blown dead. We got one official with his foot on a first down. We got Alabama with the ball in their hands, Daquan Menzie. And now the referee comes over, and Mike McQuarrie says, somebody make a call.
Remember, because of the head
injury. Moving on the field, as the ball carrier's knee was on the ground before the ball came out, before the runner is down, it results in a first down.
If Penn State gets the call, they go
review,
deep.
The ruling on the field is the ball was fumbled before the runner was down, and there was a clear recovery by Alabama. It'll be Alabama's ball, first and 10 at the 50.
That's why we have reviews.
Yeah,
that's the right call. McCarron in the shotgun. He's looking Mays his way, but he's going to have to come up short to Trent Richardson, his safety valve. And Richardson got about six before he lost his helmet on the hit by Michael Mowdy. And the Penn State crowd knows it. That's Mays that was in motion. Now he sets up on a wing to the right on third down and three. McCarron, the quick throw is complete. Got it out. And a first down to Kevin Norwood. That's his first catch of the day. First down at the 37. Here's the stretch to Richardson. Nice run by Trent Richardson, one of the best he's had. Five-yard pickup. We check in with Robert Flores. They picked up their last third down on a quick throw by McCarron. This time he's under center with Trent Richardson behind him. And he's going to roll the throw to Richardson. Got it to him, and he got the first down and then some. Diving forward near the 22-yard line. Seventh play of the drive. Third down passing, A.J. McCarron's been spot on. Here he is on first down to Richardson again. And he's brought down by Jordan Hill. That's Smelly in motion. McCarron to the middle and inside the five. It's first and goal to Kevin Norwood. And it's first and goal. McCarron has hit five different receivers on third down. This 47-yard drive has got him set up maybe for another touchdown here. Trent Richardson on the carry. And he's in. Touchdown. Tied.
And that leads to second and 10. And that leads to trouble against this defense.
And that leads to a counter play to Red. He tried this one earlier. Didn't get much. This time they got about seven. But the clock will wind down, and that might be it for the first half. So Penn State Their opening drive took them basically the length of the field. They had to settle for a field goal. They were in Alabama territory before Service fumbled again, and that turned in to an Alabama touchdown late in the second quarter. And that's where we're going to be at halftime. So the defense did its job. Let's see if the special teams can come up with a play. Kick is high and short. Fair catch taken at the 38-yard line by Justin Brown. So only a 34-yard punt, no return.
This is the guy that's got to get going for Penn State. Derek Moy, very quiet.
He's bowling off play action, and the pass is complete to Derek Moy. Right on cue from Ty Blackledge and a pickup of 11. That's his first catch. Fair to punt. Marquise Mays camps under it and lets it go. Can Penn State get to it? Nope, not before it got to the end zone. So Alabama and A.J. McCarron will take over at the 20-yard line. Again, a mile in the air, but short. And the field position is tied. That'll be good by Justin Brown at the 46-yard line. He hit it about 50 yards in the air, but only 31 yards downfield. Penn State on offense, down two touchdowns when we come back. He's going to back Mays up, that's for sure. He's going to take it at the five. Tough call, but maybe he'll make it pay. Marquise Mays on the return down the sideline. And he's all the way out near midfield.
Well, he got an incredible block from a true freshman, Vinny Sinceri.
Trent Richardson off the right side, carrying Devin Still with him for about 6 or 7 yards. Second down at three. Brandon Gibson in motion. They'll just work Trent Richardson now. He's got a first down, and he's taking would-be tacklers with him again. Richardson comes out as the extra receiver of an empty backfield for McCarron. Four-man rush. He throws over the middle, and it's Norwood. Does he have the first down? I think so.
Holly mentioned the two guys that eventually will be joining that wide receiving group.
McCarron, and they blow this play dead.
Prior to the snap, false start, 17 offense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
That is a first penalty against Alabama today. In the shotgun, second down at 14. McCarron with a pocket to work and a deep ball to Williams. Nice throw and catch inside the 10. Just outside the Penn State 7. Here's a stretch play to Trent Richardson to the corner. Did he get there? Linesman's right there, and he says no at about the 1 yard line. 18-yard field goal attempt by Jeremy Shelley. And it is right through the middle. So Penn State wins that battle a little bit as they hold the tie to just three more with 4:50 remaining here in the third quarter. 20-3, Alabama out in front. Here's Bolden off play action. Wants a deep ball on the sideline. Oh, one-handed catch by Moy. And there he went and used that 6'5 frame in front of Daquan Minzie. Third down. 10 here for Penn State. Bolden loads it, fires, and it's complete. Justin Brown has got a first down.
Good protection by the Penn State offensive line. Alabama chose to only rush four.
Brandon Beecham has checked back in at tailback. He's seen limited duty so far today. They fake it to him. And Bolden loads and goes long, and this one's intercepted by Mark Maron. Again underthrown, and this time the All-American safety and two-time captain was waiting on it. It's going to be Eddie Lacy this time. He's bouncing off Lyons for about 8 yards. In fact, we'll call it second down and one. Marquise Mays in motion. Lacy again, big opening for Lacy into the secondary before they can bring him down out at the 28-yard line. With Ty Blackledge and Holly Rowe, I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us on a beautiful day in Happy Valley. I'm going to be so happy if they don't find a comeback in the next 15 minutes. Justin Brown's going to take this one at the 28-yard line. Dancing his way for a nifty little return out to the 36. Just can't stand that, Shaw. Sorry, I don't like the Wizard of Oz either, so just bury me. On the ground, almost a face mask there, and we might have a call or a horse collar as flags fly into the 41-yard line.
Personal foul, face mask, number 30 of the defense. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run, automatic first down.
Hangs this punt up. Bounces at the 5, but again, coverage team can't get down there. Take a wicked bounce. 45-yard punt. It's a touchback, though. And it'll be a 20-yard line for Alabama. Joe Pa looking on. Only 13 minutes to go. The Tide and their fans like what they see.
College Football Hall of Famer.
Mm-hmm. Here's Trent Richardson. And Richardson's going to fight his way for almost 8 yards. And they still have not taken him down. The crimson and white of Alabama.
I think it's classy looking. I love it.
The white border got too big. Was that what they said?
It's a little too fancy.
Yeah. Here's McCarron throwing out in the flat to Smelly. And Smelly brought down at the 40-yard line with a first down.
It goes back to Bear and Joe.
Yep. Mandel, the punt. And it's going to bounce in front of the return man. This time they can advance it because there was no fair catch. And Justin Brown will take it out across the 35 to the 36. A little over 10 minutes remaining. The Houndstooth Caps out in the sunshine in Happy Valley right now with a 20-3 lead. And I thought, now there's a Penn State fan that did the best she could for the Alabama folks who are visiting from Tuscaloosa. McGloin down the sideline. Incomplete. A little too far in front of Moy. Now, wait a minute. Penalty at the very end of the play.
Pass interference on the defense, number 21. It's a 15-yard penalty for the previous spot. Automatic first down.
It's a big play, too, on a penalty. And Alabama hasn't had many penalties today, that's for sure. It will be done in just under 10 minutes on the clock, that is. Here's a sprint draw to Beecham. And he goes for 8 or 9. You got to convert. You got to get a touchdown at the end of this drive. Down 17. And straight ahead, Beecham's got it. They faked the end around after they went straight ahead. And he has the first down at about the 38-yard line. Nittany Lions' deepest penetration has been the Alabama 26. So if they get a first down here, they'll be right around the closest they've been to the goal line. Here is an end around. Devon Smith, he's got McGloin out as a blocker. And he lost the ball. And Barron, does he have it? Alabama looked to get their hands on it first, and they have it. Another big play defensively has given Alabama the ball back at its own 35-yard line. And the Eddie Lacy shedding the first tackle and the second and almost the third and almost a 10-yard gain. Second down and a yard. Run blitz. Lacy straight up the middle. He's got the first down, and he's got about 3 after that.
On the other side, I think Penn State's quarterback situation has gotten even muddier. I don't know that it's gotten any better or any clearer by today's performance.
You know, Bolden had a scoring drive, though it was a field goal the first time he had it. The second time he did an okay job, and then they went to McGloin in the third series and the fourth series. And the first 7.5 minutes of the first quarter, they had reason to think that way, and so did their fans. And Lacy now with a big opening up the middle again. Broke a tackle. Lacy inside the 20. Rumbles his way down inside the 15. Keeping it on the ground. Trent Richardson, and he's in. Touchdown, Alabama. Great to have two backs that good. Interchangeable. And Trent Richardson, his second touchdown on the ground today. And his fifth of the year. And McGloin still rather bold and now back in at quarterback. And he goes down the middle and got it complete to Allen Robinson, the freshman. That's his first catch.
I think that it's better off to have one guy that you go with. I just don't know that either one of these guys has made it clear.
Yeah.
Come on, Rob.
Here's Bolden, who's the better of the two runners, doing what he does better than McGloin, and he got a first down. Second down and 6. Here is Bolden firing, completes inside the 30. They're down close to their deepest penetration into Alabama territory. On second down at 10 at the 28. Bolden steps up in the pocket. He's going to take off with it again. Oh, man, and a head-on shot, and off came the helmet. C.J. Mosley. I got to give him credit for popping up as quickly as he did. And a give, and another collision, but it's going to be a first down run for Silas Red.
The only thing I'll say about this defense, I don't know how strong they are up front, just with their normal front three or four in terms of rushing the passer with just three or four.
This one in out of the hands of Brandon Beecham. And for all practical purposes, that was about the ball
holding
game.
Offense 67, 10-yard penalty, still second down.
Penn State running out of times. Time and going to the corner. Sean Kersey with a great catch at the 1 yard line.
I heard they had videos of the second half of that Auburn game right, running through their weight room all during their lifting sessions in the winter.
Airborne is Red. Second effort. Almost lost the ball, but he's in. Touchdown. They might look at this one too, but for right now it's Silas Red for a touchdown. So let's see if they can pick up the 2-point conversion and then the onside kick that'll be upcoming. Bolden might run for this one. Dives and got it.
Nice quick decision.
Evan Lewis will do the honors. A good hands team for Alabama. All up there 10 to 15 yards away from the football. This one's got a chance, but it's covered by Alabama, and they'll take over with a minute 52. Brad Smelly, they've gotten better from a week ago, and they give you the impression that maybe the sky is the limit for this team, at least with the defense they have. And as this guy grows into his jersey, number 10, A.J. McCarron.
You know, Liberty ball used to be in Philadelphia.
The Liberty, Liberty, you know, the Liberty bell. I didn't know that before they moved it to Tennessee. So you learn something every day. Especially when you're around Joe Paterno, who is a national treasure, in my opinion. There's physical toughness, and there's moral toughness. And if any guy in college football's ever had the moral part of it, it's Joe Paterno with what he's done at Penn State. I thought those were nicely said by Nick.
I like how he explained it, too. I mean, moral toughness being doing the right thing no matter what the circumstances are.
Right.
And that's what Joe Paterno has been about, doing the right thing. And you know what? I think Nick Saban is doing the right thing at Alabama as well.
Now they get a big win on the road, that's for sure. They thought it would be tough, and for at least part of the game it was. But then the Alabama defense stiffened, made things very tough on the two quarterbacks of Penn State, including Rob Bolden and Matt McGloin. And it's 27-11 as we go down to Holly.
Now, Coach, I know you say it wasn't executed perfectly, but that fake punt really set a tone and gave your guys some juice. How did that really turn that first half around for you guys?
Well, you know, I think the punt return in the second half was the thing that changed the field position and the momentum of the game and got us ahead in the game. I was a little bit disappointed the way we played 2 minutes at the end of the game defensively. There's always a lot of things you need to work on at this time of the year, but this is a great win for our team. It's a great win for the state of Alabama and all of our fans and people. This is a tough place to come and play, and I'm proud of our guys and the way they competed today.
Thank you, Coach.
All right, thank you.
Only Nick Saban would be worried about the last drive against his defense that made it 27-11. That's our final score, Alabama number 3 over Penn State. Don't forget, Notre Dame and Michigan tonight on ESPN. Coming up next, NASCAR Sprint Cup Series at Richmond. For Todd Blackledge, Holly Rowe, and our entire crew, Brad Nessler, saying so long from Penn State.